having an impact factor of 4.964 and publication year 2023. Introduction. The multiple sclerosis, MS, is a chronic disabling neurological disorder that reports 3:1 ratio in a prevalence of female to males. MS is a disease in which immune system eats away the protective covering of nerves and in result, nerve damage disturbs communication between brain and body, in which the body's immune system mounts, flare-ups, or an attack against the central nervous system. MS causes inflammation, demyelination, and scary means sclerosis in the white matter of brain and spinal cord. Need of the study. In COVID-19 pandemic, when most gyms did not offer exceptional services for this high-risk MS patient, and this patient still desire to keep social distance, there have not been enough comparative studies to examine the effect of tele-yoga and tele-pilates as a user-friendly and cost-effective. Inclusion criteria. RRMS means relapsing remitting multiple sclerosis female, self-reported age 18 to 65, expanded disability status scale 0 to 5.5, and body mass index 20 to 32, and participant signed consent form. Exclusion criteria, pregnancies, drug and alcohol addiction, history of cardiovascular disease, abnormal metabolic history, cancer, orthopedic disorder, exercise in previous 3 months, and relapse in previous 3 months. This is the demographic data they have collected. This first three is EDSS and BMI is an inclusion criteria, and last three is employment and unemployment ratio, a diploma and university education, and mean year of disease onset. Research objective. Primary objective is to evaluate the effect of an online program of yoga and pilates as a complementary non-pharmacological therapy on prolactin, cortisol, serum level, depression, mental health, quality of life, physical activity level, and walking speed in female with MS. Research design. Three-arm RCT, or you can say three-group, three-post design. 45 participants were randomly assigned to one of three groups, control, tele-yoga, tele-pilates, exercise, and 15 in each group. Now, source of the sample, mainly RRMS patients were recruited from the local MS society, Siraj MS Center in Iran, and dissemination of posters and participation information leaflets on social media and text messages to members of MS society. Research design. Sample size were decided through G-Power software, and from there they found sample size of 42. After counting 10% dropouts, 45 participants were selected, and they were randomized in three groups by using simple randomization procedures. Consort diagram. See, 71 people were eligible. Out of that, 15 were excluded, not meeting inclusion criteria, and declined to participate. Finally, 56 people randomized into the tele-pilates 20, tele-yoga 19, and control group 17. After follow-up, some dropouts, finally, they analyzed for tele-pilates 15, tele-yoga 15, and control group 15. Assessment tool. For the cortisol and prolactin serum level, blood sample of 25 ml was taken, and this laboratory of Iran, they have tested for, and ELISA kit were used, back depression inventory, general health questionnaire, international physical activity questionnaire, timed 25 foot walk, and MS quality of life questionnaire. Tele-yoga and tele-pilates intervention. This was the online supervised intervention, 8 weeks, three times per week, 24 sessions. And it is each session was 60 minutes, included three-phase warming up, 10 to 15 minutes, main pose is 30 to 40 minutes, and cool down, 10 to 15 minutes. They have used Hatha yoga, asana, dhyana, and pranayama. Each poses were held for 10 to 30 seconds, and 32 seconds to 1 minute relaxation was given between asanas. And these are the exercises for tele-pilates. We are not going into the detail. data analysis. SPSS software were used version 26, and for normality, numerical and graphical in numericals, Shapiro will test for normality, skewness, and kurtosis values, and for graphical, histogram and QQ plot. Significance level was p less than 0.05. This is the table. These are the three groups, Tele Pilots, Tele Yoga, and control group. And here the significance value, what the result has come for p-value is given. Prolactin, cortisol, BDI, back depression inventory, general health questionnaire, international physical activity questionnaire, and time 25-foot walk. And this in questionnaire, MS questionnaire, quality of life, there is a mental health composite and physical health composite. Here they have given mean plus or minus standard deviation. Like here you can see 20.79 and it is 20.83, means prolactin level is increased. If you see in all the area, prolactin is increased, whereas in control group, prolactin level from 21.74 to 25.46, it is decreased. So prolactin is decreased, whereas cortisol, if you see the all three groups, cortisol has in two groups, it is decreased. And in the control group, it has increased because control group is not given any intervention. This way you can see all the data. And here, if you can see the wherever the star is been marked, these all got significance level p less than 0.05. This is the graph. Actually, data itself is a self-explanatory. I have taken only two graphs. They have given eight graphs. So here, only prolactin and cortisol I have taken. Conclusion: the investigation result after 8 weeks of Tele Pilots and Tele Yoga in female with MS showed an increase in prolactin serum, which may help myelin repairment. A decrease in cortisol that may be caused by existing HPA dysregulation. Improvement in the depression that may be due to the reduction in cortisol serum level and vice versa. Enhancement of physical activity level, walking speed, and quality of life. Findings suggest the feasibility of Tele Yoga and Tele Pilates as non-pharmacological add-on therapies that may have beneficial impact on hormonal expression and physical and mental health factor in females with MS. Strength of this study: the constraint on going to the gyms and rehabilitation centers were partially resolved for this patient, who have limitation due to their bladder and physical function problems. In addition, authors made homes for this high-risk group of contracting COVID-19 a safer place to exercise. Limitation: intervention period was limited to long duration for future tele-intervention will be recommended. Study only assessed the effect of tele-exercise on female with RRMS, therefore, result might not be generalized for the patient type of MS and such as primary progressive multiple sclerosis patient and secondary progressive multiple sclerosis and another gender like male. These are the references. 76 references are there. Thank you.
Very nice, short and sweet, sweet presentation, ma'am.
Yes. But I am not able to see anyone.
Oh, very good presentation, Bharti ma'am.
Thank you. I am not able to see who has given the comment. Can I stop my presentation so I can see you people?
No, continue.
Okay, fine.
Listen.
Okay, fine, sir. Yeah, any questions?
Yes, Sumit sir, Prajakta ma'am.
Yes, Bharti ma'am. Can you go to the inclusion criteria slide?
Yes.
So here they have taken that RRMS female. as per the McDonald's criteria. Can you explain what is RRMS females?
Actually, here also I mentioned, but still, relapsing remitting multiple sclerosis. It means there are actually four stages. This article has not mentioned clearly, but usually other articles always mention all four stages. First stage is RRMS. It's relapsing remitting multiple sclerosis. It means this patient got neurological disorder in that they get relapse. Here relapsing means attacks. They autoimmune attacks on the nerve cell myelin sheath. It's a fatty substance that they eat away. Yeah, they make a scar on it. And these first stages, 80 to 90% patients are of this stage.
Okay. So what exactly happens in this relapsing remitting stage, madam?
Actually, the attacks come at that time, they have no other option. They have to take corticosteroid treatment in either in-house or either in the hospital. Normally 5 days they keep in the hospital 1 gram of corticosteroid they give it to patient, and after that there will be remission period, like they will be recovering. Remitting period means recovery period start, and normally maybe 6 months, maybe year, maybe some people don't get relapsing for maybe one more than 2 years also. It depends on patient to patient. It's a attack at that time, they get severe problem for so many symptoms, and they get disability sometimes. They, if it is attacks on like on optic nerve, then they get double vision or blur vision or something like that. It means nerves wherever in the body, wherever attack is there, that part gets affected.
Okay. And second thing, in exclusion criteria, they have first mentioned the pregnancy. Can you elaborate this?
Yeah, actually, if you see that they have taken one of the measure is prolactin. So in prolactin, we cannot measure the in pregnancy. Prolactin level will vary with the compared to normal female. That is the one reason. Another pregnancy is whether they'll be able to do this. That could be one of the reason. But normally, main the reason is prolactin. They have written taken as a measure assessment tool.
Yes, actually in pregnancy, prolactin level goes very high.
Very high. So we cannot actually make out whether it's effective or not.
Yes, yes.
Another reason in prolactin level is high in the pregnancy, usually they don't get relapses in pregnancy period time. That is the survey says.
Yes. And in the research objective slide, can you go to the research objective slide?
Yes.
So they have taken this primary objective as a prolactin.
Actually, all three they have taken, but you can see, biomarker they have taken prolactin as well as cortisol serum.
Can you explain what is the correlation of multiple sclerosis and prolactin?
Actually, prolactin increases. That is, again, I'll tell you, this both the biomarker is not proved. This is the second or third article they have taken this, but none of biomarker is proved other than MRI and CSF fluid, you know. So still they have taken, but still nobody can prove that, because prolactin increasing means their relapses will reduce, or either multiple sclerosis progress will be reduced. Or if we see cortisol also have a contradictory effect, because they have given hormone as a treatment, so automatically cortisol level increases, and that shows the drug is affecting. And at the same time, because of cortisol, they get the stress and depression. So it's a contradictory there. And even there are article basal cortical level of still they are also telling there is still, they cannot exactly say the progress is okay or not.
Yes, actually, this is the problem with both prolactin and cortisol, that prolactin and cortisol both are showing relieving effects on MS also, and both are showing aggravating effects on MS. None of them is proved yet.
Yes, you are right.
Yes, that is why I asked.
And that's why if you say I underlined in the, for example, I underlined in the conclusion, they've given the conclusion, but I underlined in may. See, here it is may, here it is may.
yes. Okay, very nice presentation, Bhartiji.
Thank you, ma'am. Any other questions, please?
Your understanding also is very clear about you, that, sir. And that is also very helpful to us. You have gone through the all the paper, what exactly if term used in this
yeah, paper, actually, you know, I have referred
understand actually, all the things. That's why you are very,
yes, sir.
Humbly you can say everything on that paper. That is very, yes, appreciated. Sir.
Thank you, sir.
So Bharti ji,
yes ma'am,
I just wanted to ask then, if no biomarker is proved to be specific in MS, do you think, or have you read that this specific biomarker we can take in further studies?
Actually, ma'am, I have met 3 neurologists because I am going to take this topic in my PhD. I okay. met 3 neurologists because I wanted to take different view from different doctors. So all 3 of them told that there is exactly a laboratory biomarker is not there except MRI and CSF. Like, this is the only, and that also they are testing for only after 1 year, just to safer side to check if there is a further progression or not. Otherwise, if it is not needed, they are not checking. And they all doctors clinically only they check with the either this EDSS and either balance scales and all. They clinically only check progression because they are expert. They can make out from clinical only. And even MRI is also quite costly, 12,000 to 15,000 with injection. They do MRI in this.
Yes, this is right. But again, I think oxidative stress is one concept. It can or may get affected.
It will actually, what I am telling is like in MS and normal person, it will be affecting in both. So how will conclude that in MS it is different and normal person is different?
Sorry, ma'am, I didn't got you.
See, oxidative stress, even with the normal human being, also if you do yoga intervention, there will be improvement in that also. And in MS also, there will be maybe improvement. So how we can compare? Like in MS, it has made much difference than normal human being.
Okay, healthy, yes, obviously. Yes, in healthy human being also you can, but I think in MS the oxidative stress might be too much of hampered, because have you ever read any paper regarding to oxidative stress and MS?
No, in MS I have not gone through, because I have gone through nearly 65 papers, and out of that 34 was experimental, and nearly 30 it was review articles or systematic review. But still, I have not searched all the, like Web of Science I have searched, Google Scholar I have searched, PubMed. Still, I have not used all the keys, but I could find in PubMed 20 articles. I have not gone through Scopus, I have not gone through other science magazines, but still my search is going on.
Okay, so I'm not saying it's a biomarker. It can be a biomarker for multiple sclerosis, that is oxidative stress, but it might be one of the factors that I'm saying, if you can see or you can search for any paper for oxidative stress and MS, it will be great, or it will help you, I guess.
Yeah, you are right. Actually, I'm still in, I have taken in my topic, I have taken 4-3 scale and 1 questionnaire. Previously, I had taken adrenocorticotropic hormones and cortisol both. But after meeting my neurologist, and another reason is also I am not eligible for JRF because my age is high. And another thing is I am not even eligible for fellowship also. So I have no fund to spend so much money on ACTH and cortisol. And luckily, my neurologist also said that there is no point, just because of just doing test, it's fine, but you cannot find out progress. It has progressed or not, yes. You cannot find out. So there is no point in spending money on that. But still, I'm in searching because I've talked to two neurologists that if you can, they give me some laboratory test that, you know, give support to this this research. So they said can find and they'll tell me as soon as they get time to find it out.
Okay, Bhartiji, all the best.
Thank you, ma'am.
Any diet related concept you have read about MS?
Pardon, I couldn't get you, sir.
Any diet related concept regarding to the MS? Or any specific diet is?
Yeah, that usually there is an article on nutrition. I have downloaded one article. Normally, I talk to 4-5 MS patients. They have told that they observing themselves by three of them said the curd is not good for them, yogurt like, and other things also they tell. But that also consideration, I have taken a list and before I start my intervention, and I am going to lead one or two introduction about the diet and lifestyle, and then I'll start my intervention. That is what I'm thinking of. I'm in search of it.
Okay.
But yes, definitely it affects the diet. Diet is quite important in this.
That means you are incorporating diet in also in your research.
I'm not exactly incorporating, but as you said, we say mitahar or yogic ahar. Without yogic ahar, our asanas won't be effective. So we need to educate them and let's see how much they can follow themselves. But there is no actually exact as such criteria we are going to insist them.
Include in your research topic also, that will be more beneficial to your patient also, and even uniqueness of your topic, that may be.
Yeah, you are quite right. Actually, otherwise there won't be great benefit in this. You are quite right.
Second thing, any related to temperature, you have seen that paper.
Yeah, actually there is also contradiction. Like this MS, if you see, a prevalence of MS is more near equator, far from equator, countries far from equator, they are having more. Means in the cold places, MS is more. For example, Iran, Canada, they are too much MS patient. If you see the research article maximum of Iran, and this article is also from Iran. So that is one reason. Another thing is MS patient face more difficulty of symptoms in summer. So both is little bit contradictory. Heat sensitive, these symptoms are there. So I've been suggested by MS patient only that when you start intervention, please start in winter. So I said, okay, I'll start in winter.
Great, you have understand all minute points about the MS, and you will definitely do very better your research.
Thank
your
you.
Contribution in MS and yoga, that will be very helpful to people also.
Sir, this is only for PhD point of view, but in fact, MS I have taken means after PhD also, I'll be taking different research in MS only, because I worked hard in, you know, finding MS patient, and still I'm finding, and a lot of procedure I have to go through to do this work, you know. It's a quite big procedure.
May I ask, Bhartiji, how many groups you are taking in your research?
Two groups, control group and intervention group.
And for how many days of intervention?
3 weeks, 3 months. 3 months, 5 days a week. In fact, I supposed to take twice 5 days a week, but I am taking only one, because which intervention module I have taken from Sridhar Palkuruji's validated module I have taken. Somehow they have not taken any feasibility test that will be done. I have just Vasudevan from India, I have check only individualized case study from Vasudevan, G and other India, there is no experimental research. Still I have come across, they all are from other countries. But I had taken one tuition for one patient in long back, but that was good positive response in that on behalf, and somehow I could started finding MS patient now with the two clinic I found, one hospital I found, and still I have to approach so many people, so many neurologists, so might be I'll be getting. So that's why I have taken quasi experimental only, but by chance if I find more and get all Ahmedabad data, then might be I can do randomized also, but I'm not in hurry to do randomized right now. I want to check proper feasibility.
Okay, Bharti ji, all the best.
Thank you, ma'am.
This was the best presentation. All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Bharti ma'am, I would like to ask you structure-based questions, okay?
Yes, sir.
First of all, who is giving presentation have to compulsory own your camera.
Oh, yes, sir.
But you did not open.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now go back to the presentation.
Yes, sir.
My same question to you, that key only in the inclusion criteria I saw the only one reference, but in the entire your presentation very less references.
Sir, where you want me to give a reference?
Mainly references, need of the study, go to the need of the study.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's in this page here is compulsion for the references, but you did,
sir,
not mention
author. Yeah. Author him, author has not given reference. I cannot create my own reference, sir. In article,
okay,
author
please,
has not given reference.
Please check. Please check once again.
Yeah, I have article with me.
Okay.
This is an inclusion exclusion criteria. You will also study maybe in the discussion.
Okay, check yourself after the presentation. Okay.
Okay, sir.
My second question is that you mentioned that they took three groups. One is tele group, then second is yoga group. Can you explain what is tele group?
Actually, online they have given a name tele. Online, they have taken this online. Just let me take out the
what online.
Online, like intervention, they have taken online. Okay, the classes.
Which intervention?
Yoga as well as tele pilots, both.
My question is that now, what is tele? What is the meaning here, tele?
Here they themselves has given a tele yoga as a name. And tele pilots is a name. Just a minute, let me switch on the light. They've given a name as a tele yoga and tele because they have taken this intervention online, supervised intervention online. Actually,
okay,
author has not mentioned anything about tele, what is tele and tele pilots. It's like understood it is taken online, that's why they have given tele as a specific tele yoga as a word.
And what is tele pilots?
Tele pilots, it's a set of exercise. Like here in last, you can see exercise were performed while added. It's a sort of exercises like neutral
spine. Can you let us know which kind of exercise they taken? Because it's the rarely disease and module is also hardly to find.
Can
So
you
which
see
kind
the
of exercise they selected in this paper? Yeah.
Actually, this is the last point in tele pilots and tele intervention. The last, whatever point I mentioned, that much only is mentioned in the paper. Like they have
Prone.
prone, sitting, supine, and 4-point kneeling and side lying and standing. These are the various postures, and they have done exercise in these. And if it is
Do you
required,
think, as per your knowledge, do you think it is enough or not? Because prone posture, many more postures. Which kind of prone postures? Standing asana, hundreds of standing asanas. I think so. You should mention that it is the limitation of this paper, no? But you did not mention, no?
I mentioned, they mentioned limitation, not mine. But if you ask
no,
me, then I'll
according
tell
you. No, according to you, no. Here you are presented, na. You use your mind and find the limitation of the paper, and you have to mention that limitation in the presentation.
Yeah, that's right. Then there
not
is
not 100% copy. Research paper may be wrong, not 100% right. So
right.
You are the presenting, so it's your responsibility. You try to find the limitations more. Many more researchers, they do not mention the limitations, but clearly, it's clearly we can see ki there are many more limitations we can see here.
You
so
right,
you
sir.
Should mention that limitations. Okay.
Okay, sir. Then there is so many limitation I can tell you. I found.
Yeah, you should mention. No,
like,
it's your work. No, that's
for
why
example,
need to presentation.
See,
no.
Sir, if you see here, prolating, they have written ng per milliliter. Actually, ng is not a measurement. It should be milligram. Here, cortisol, they have mentioned microgram per dl. And if you see the graph, they have milligram per dl. They have mentioned that itself is wrong.
Yes. Yes. This is the way of presenting paper. When you are commenting on a paper, you need to mention all the aspects. That means limitation, what is their, what they have done mistake in that point, and what they have achieved by publishing this paper.
There is a small.
You need to try to put more focus, because after that, reading such minute thing, you will understand how we can write or how we can minimize our mistakes in writing paper or conducting study.
You are right, sir. And one more thing, there is no data is given in Hatha Yoga. What are the asanas? What are things they have taken? But they have, in article they have mentioned. If anybody wants data, they are open for it. So in fact, to find the detail, we need to mail them and find things in detail, other data.
Most of the time, because of the limitation of words, most of journal give that kind of things. Otherwise, in concise manner, you can give the additional file in your paper also.
Right, sir.
Yeah, nice thing. Okay. Good.
Actually, my mistake, I thought I have to mention only those things which is in article. Because it is
that is okay. Limitations, what you contributed in this presentation? You are 100% copy paste.
Yeah, right.
Presentation means what you find something new in this paper, na? That is, no?
So I thought,
and
that
which kind of new idea?
Which
kind of new idea you got in this paper? Now let me know.
A new idea, actually, I presented because even I am going to take this as a topic, so I am also facing all Ahmedabad I have taken. And different areas. So if 5 days a week, if it is possible, one day I will do physically face to face, and 4 days, yeah, 3 days, if I can do online, if it is successful, then you know their moving problem will be solved, because these people have a balance issue and disability issue, and some support is required to drop them into the yoga places, and somebody has to pick up. That is a limitation. So that could be resolved by this, by seeing
now,
this article.
Okay. Now you are also agree, and we all agree ki that MS patients, they have the balancing problem. And now, can you assume ki if you are giving online intervention, will be useful? Will they follow properly? And maybe they online yoga harmful for them?
Actually, this is what I am telling you. I till now I have planned to do 5 days physically only, but if this constraint I can resolve by this, either instead of 5 days, 2 days I can do physically and 3 days I can do, you know, 2 days first I'll do physically so I can see how they are performing, how they are able to do, they are facing any issue or not. In fact, maybe possible few weeks also I can continue, and then when they are comfortable I can switch over.
No, you have to clear. No, it's not right way. This you is, have to kill, yeah.
This is, you know, initial stage I am discussing only.
If they are doing balancing problem, is there still you are doing yoga online?
No, course? actually we EDSS, that balancing won't be that serious in RRMS patient, because we are taking here they see one mistake also I found. Inclusion criteria they have written, you know, 0 to 5.5. Actually, 0 is no problem. Actually, 1 to 5.5 they are supposed to mention. Not a single article you will find 0 to 5.5. They will say 1 to 5.5, yeah, 1 to 4. If there is a 10 levels. So normally what I am going to take is 1 to 5 only, not more than 5.
And Bhartiji, I want to ask one question. Yes. What precautions are necessary to take when you are instructing or taking yoga sessions for MS patient? To be very specific.
Exactly. Precautions mainly, previously I, in fact, what precautions I need to do that before I finalizing that, I am going to interact with each and every person when I am finding inclusion criteria, because even this article, in this article also author had the online conversation one by one, and then they finalize the patient. So that need to be done, because what I've seen, maximum papers are of foreign countries, and only one Vasudevanji's article I've seen of India, but he has given in detail, but still it was in Hyderabad chapter, but south. And my, again, in Gujarat, so geographical factor-wise, or if there is another difference in symptoms, I am going to meet even neurologists regarding this. Till now, I have not decided exactly what precaution, but I am in the process of making the list of it.
So basically, their muscle activity is not that strong like a normal healthy individual. So you should be very careful while taking different yoga courses.
Yeah, you are very right. Actually, what I have met one lady also RRMS. She is computer engineer and she is working full time. And I met another lady from Kapadwan. She is also working in. So two working lady I had talked, and they said initially they had a relaxed time they face problem, afterwards in remissing period normally they don't face. So my title is in remissing period only I am going to take them.
Yes, please look at it. Yeah, once
that's so, in fact for ethical reason also I have to make the list and get the approval. You are right, it's a very most important point.
Thank you, sir. So, Mr. and Prajakta ma'am, are you accepting her presentation?
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
From my side, I am accepting this paper. Because I think we had a good discussion regarding the basic concept of MS.
Yes, Sumit sir.
Yes, from my side, this is yes, because all the concept is very clear. And second thing, Bharti ma'am has been warned very clearly about all the concept, and even she has been deciding her topic, who is presenting next time, that should be considered how you can look the paper, all the concepts and very basic points which has been taken in that paper and how we should comment on this. That will be very beneficial to us also to understand the paper.
Yeah. Nice presentation. It's my turn now.
Thank you, sir.
I will only accept when you will send the limitations.
Yes, sir.
So
it will
work
be done.
Today you have full night. Work
yes,
on
sir.
It.
Done, sir. There
tomorrow is Aditi's presentation. Maybe I will give you a chance after Aditi. Or you can make the single video and send the group. Then I will accept.
Okay, sir.
Read
yes.
again
I...
and notice all the limitations again.
Okay, sir.
I also
I'll enjoy doing it.
Yeah, other
I
thing
also agree
nice.
With Rahul Bhaiya that you should mention the limitations of the paper. This is very most important thing in the paper presentation.
You are quite right about it.
Basically, criticize
yeah.
the paper.
Yeah. Now, if any other scholars or members who want to ask any kind of question to Bharti ma'am, can ask. In the group, anyone have any doubt? No questions? So okay, now we can close this session. All of you, I'm stopping the recording, okay, because I want to discuss others also. First, I'm stopping the recording, please wait. Yeah, okay.